بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا تجعل حزنا والصعب إذا ما شئت سهلا اللهم آمين. So alhamdulillah, we're now exploring Surah Yunus, which is carrying the name of one of the prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is a surah that comes after Surah At-Tawbah. And Surah At-Tawbah, we explored yesterday, was a surah that is, you know, very loaded. And one of the beautiful things that connects between the Surah At-Tawbah and Surah Yunus is that, you know, it speaks about the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jal concluded Surah At-Tawbah by saying, وَإِذَا مَا أُنزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ أَيُّكُمْ زَادَتْهُ وَإِذَا مَا أُنزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ نَظَرَ بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ, referring to the Quran. So, and the same thing is to be said in Surah Yunus. Allah Azza wa Jal started the surah by saying, أَلِفْ لَامْ رَا تِلْكَ آيَاتُ الْكِتَابِ الْحَكِيمِ. You know, these are indeed the ayat of the book that is hakim, with wise. You know, wisdom is full in this book. And this, you know, theme of Quran continues throughout the chapter. Allah Azza wa Jal talks about this chapter as, or this book as, you know, a revelation from Allah Azza wa Jal. وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يُفْتَرَى مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. Throughout the chapter, Allah Azza wa Jal, you know, speaks about the Quran. And then, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مُعِظَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Subhanallah, this ayah, by the way, is so beautiful. So beautiful ayah. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O mankind, not believers, mankind, قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, here comes to you a reminder from your Lord. وَهُدًى and guidance, وَرَحْمَةً لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. You know, this book that Allah Azza wa Jal revealed is guidance to all mankind, but it is huda wa rahma lil mu'minin, a guidance and rahma to the believers. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. And Allah Azza wa Jal reminds us about how beautiful this rahma from Allah Azza wa Jal, say by the blessings of Allah Azza wa Jal and His mercy, فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا, we should be happy, we should be excited, we should be, you know, thankful to Allah Azza that we're chosen to be the people of the Quran, Ummat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then even, you know, this theme of, you know, speaking about the Quran comes at the end of the chapter. فَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي شَكٍّ مِمَّا أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ فَاسْأَلَ الَّذِينَ يَقْرَؤُونَ الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَقَدْ جَاءَكَ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكَ فَلَا تَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُمْتَرِينَ. You know, asking people to reflect and contemplate on the books that has been revealed from before, so that they get to know that this is real, you know, message from Allah Azza wa Jal. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ قَدْ جَاءَكُمُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ اِهْتَدَى فَإِنَّمَا يَهْتَدِي لِنَفْسِهِ وَمَنْ ضَلَّ فَإِنَّمَا يَضِلُّ عَلَيْهَا وَمَا أَنَا عَلَيْكُمْ بِوَكِيلٍ. Allah Azza says, O mankind, again, addressing mankind, قَدْ جَاءَكُمُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, here comes the truth from your Lord. فَمَنْ اِهْتَدَى, whoever gets guided, whoever follows the guidance, فَإِنَّمَا يَهْتَدِي لِنَفْسِهِ, will be doing favor to himself or herself. وَمَنْ ضَلَّ, and whoever, you know, goes astray, فَإِنَّمَا يَضُلُّ عَلَيْهَا وَمَا أَنَا عَلَيْكُمْ بِوَكِيلٍ. And Allah Azza wa Jal is saying, whoever, you know, chooses the path of dalal, mischief or unguidance, that's, you know, goes back to himself or herself. Now, another, you know, beautiful, you know, connection between the two surahs at the end of that surah, Allah Azza says, قُلْ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا, you know, referring to لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَءُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. You know, describing the nature of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how the Prophet was so, you know, patient, and how he was so keen to invite the believers, and how he's so, you know, full of rahma. But at the same time, Allah will conclude this surah, فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا, and if they abstain from your path, ya Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَقُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ, say حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ عليه توكلت هو رب العرش العظيم. Now there are two themes you need to follow on this in the following chapter. We'll take the last one, which is لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. You know, when they abstain, say that I believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, no god is him. He is, you know, I count on him. وهو رب العرش العظيم. Now when we go to the Surah you know, Yunus will see that Allah Azza Jal, you know, did mention issues related to the Arsh. Inna rabbakum Allahu alladhi khalaqa as-samawati wal-ardi fi sittati ayamin thumma istawa 'ala al-'arsh yudabbiru al-amra ma min shafi'in illa man ba'da idnihi. Referring to the power of Allah Azza Jal. By the way, this is a surah Makkiya. The surah Makkiya always referred to the concept of Tawheed and the rewarding of those who follow the teachings of Allah Azza wa Jal and the punishment for those who abstain from following the teachings of Allah Azza wa Jal. So, إِنَّ رَبَّكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ الْأَرْضِ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. Referring to, you know, Allah Azza wa Jal, the Mighty, is the you know, the controller and the sustainer of this universe, and He's Rabbul Arsh. And also at the same time, you know, the theme which Surah At-Tawbah concluded with is that لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِتُّمْ, describing the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then again, Allah Azza Jal in the following chapter describes, you know, speaks about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. إِنَّ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى رَجُلٍ مِنْهُمْ أَنْ أَنذِرِ أَكَانَ لِلنَّاسِ عَجَبًا أَنْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى رَجُلٍ مِنْهُمْ أَنْ أَنذِرِ النَّاسَ وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنَّ لَهُمْ قَدَمَ صِدْقٍ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ. Is it a surprise for people that Allah have you know chosen among them from them among themselves a man who you know to who gives them you know warning and glad tiding, referring to you know the punishments of abstaining and reward of getting you know of following the teachings of Allah Azza wa Jal. And you know this theme also speaking about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continues throughout the chapter and even in the conclusion of the in the stories of the prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal, you know, in this chapter, you know, Allah Azza wa Jal introduces stories of three prophets: the prophet of Nuh alayhi salam, the prophet of Musa and Harun, and the prophet of Yunus alayhi salam. And you know, some of Fasirun says that the common between these stories is that there is water involved into this, you know, life of the prophets. Nuh alayhi salam's people were drowned by the water, and you know, Fir'aun la'natullahi alayhi was also drowned, you know, hatta idha adrakahu al-gharq wa qala amantu annahu la ilaha illa alladhi amant bihi banu isra'il al-ana wa qad asayta qablu in kuntu min al-kafirin al-fasiqin al-mufsidin. And also the same is to be said in the story of Yunus alayhi salam. We know that Yunus alayhi salam was in the boat, and then eventually he was, you know, taken by the whale. So but the theme between this are also interconnected with the introduction of this chapter, and as well as with the end of Surah At-Tawbah, that Allah Azza wa Jal is consoling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ وَاتَّبِعْ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ وَاصْبِرْ حَتَّى يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal is addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, وَاتَّبِعْ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ, follow what has been revealed to you, Ya Rasulullah, وَاصْبِرْ. Because this is what, you know, the Prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal from before he had to go through, and they were patient and on what Allah Azza wa Jal had led them to go through. وَاصْبِرْ حَتَّى يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. So these stories all reveal, you know, address one you know issue, that you know they had to go through difficulties and challenges, and Allah Azza wa Jal asked them to be patient. And one of the beautiful things that, you know, the stories of all these, you know, prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal address is what is related to the, also again in the beginning of this chapter, when Allah Azza wa Jal, you know, speaks about, you know, zahrat al-hayat al-dunya, you know, inna alladhina la yarjuna liqa'ana wa radu bil hayat ad-dunya wa atma'annu biha walladhina hum an ayatina ghafilun ulaika ma'wahum an-nar bima kanu yaksibun. Those who have chosen, they are satisfied in the lowly life and abstain and forget, you know, the akhirah. أولئك مأواهم إن الذين يرجون لقاءنا ورضوا بالحياة الدنيا. Those who did not, who do not wish to meet Allah Azza wa Jal, and they were satisfied in the lowly life, وَاطْمَأَنُّوا بِهَا, they are comfortable and become, you know, happy and content in this life. والذين هم عن آياتنا غافلون, and those who are living in ghafla from the ayat Allah Azza wa Jal. أولئك مأواهم النار بما كانوا يكسبون. Their abode will be the hellfire والعياذ بالله. And then Allah Azza wa Jal, you know, describes this dunya as إنما مثل الحياة الدنيا كماء أنزلناه من السماء فاختلط به نبات الأرض مما يأكل الناس والأنعام حتى إذا أخذت الأرض زخرفها وزينت وظن أهلها أنهم قادرون عليها أتاه أمرنا نهار ليلا أو نهارا فجعلناها حصيدا كأن لم تغن بالأمس كذلك نفصل الآيات لقوم يتفكرون. Allah Azza Jal, you know, explains for us what's the reality of this life. Do not be fooled. Do not be away from, you know, remembrance of Allah Azza Jal. Do not live in ghafla, because eventually the consequences of living in ghafla would be nothing but what happened to the prophets of Allah Azza Jal's own people. Because, you know, this is what, you know, Musa alayhi salam said about Fir'aun la'natullahi alayhi, when he said, Ya Rabbana innaka atayta Fir'auna wa mala'ihi zinatan wa amwana fil hayat ad-dunya. You will see the connection between the story of these sort of prophets. You know, Fir'aun was fooled and was blinded with his own surroundings because of what Allah had given to them. Zinat al hayat ad-dunya. Innaka atayta Fir'auna wa mala'ihi zinatan wa amwana. Zina, decorations, wa amwal and money. And the same is to be said about, you know, Nuh alayhi salam. Ya qawm in kana kabura alaykum maqami wa tadkiri bi ayatillah. You know, as it is inshallah mentioned in the Surah Hud, as the Sheikh recited, that, you know, the people of Nuh, they belittled the followers of Nuh alayhi salam. They said, you know, ana nu'minu laka wa tabi'aka al-ardulun. You know, should we follow you and your followers are from the poor or the low social status. And the same is to be said in the story of Yunus alayhi salam. Yunus alayhi salam rushed and, you know, left his own people who were also very, you know, indulged into this life. So you could see the connection into the themes, these themes throughout the surah. And inshallah I conclude about something that this surah also, you know, addresses, which is something about the human nature. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَلَوْ عَجِّلُ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ الشَّرَّ اسْتِعْجَالَهُمْ بِالْخَيْرِ ولو يعجل الله للناس الشر استعجالهم الخير لقضي إليهم أجلهم فنذر الذين لا يرجون لقاءنا في طغيانهم يعمهون. وإذا مس الإنسان الضر دعانا لجنبه أو قاعدا أو قائما. When a calamity befalls into, you know, a person, they would be supplicating to Allah Azza wa Jal, you know, لجنبه, when he's on the side, or sitting, or قائما, standing. فلما كشفنا عنه الضر, and when the calamity is lifted away from him or her, then مَرَّ كَأَنْ لَمْ يَدْعُنَا لَضُرٌّ مَسَّهُ. Then, you know, he would go after that in life as if nothing happened to him. You should take calamities, difficulties, challenges are as a gift, as gifts from Allah Azza wa Jal. And you know, this is what Allah Azza wa Jal was trying to explain for us throughout even the stories of the prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal. Calamities, difficulties are not as a result of, you know, mistakes or because something wrong happened you have done in your life. It could be Allah is warning you, but at the same time, these are things to help you, you know, stay on the right path. The offer difficulty should become more, much stronger in your iman with Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is also, addressed in, throughout the chapter. هو الذي سيركم في البر والبحر حتى إذا كنتم في الفلك وجرنا بهم ريح طيبة وفرحوا بها جاءتهم ريح عاصف وجاءهم موج من كل مكان وظنوا أنهم أحيط بهم دعوا الله مخلصين له الدين لأن جئتنا من هذه لنكون من الشاكرين فلما أنجهم إذا هم يبغون في الأرض بغير الحق. Allah Azza explains, you know, beautiful, you know, scene that people in a ship, and then, you know, the wind comes and the waves become so strong, and then, you know, they lose hope in surviving. And they supplicate to Allah Azza Jal in that difficult time. And then when they are saved and go, and then, you know, they reach the shore, then eventually they go on their business as if nothing happened. The moral of this story, or the moral of this chapter, is what Allah Azza Jal said to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, وَاتَّبِعْ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ. Follow what has been revealed to you. وَاصْبِرْ. My brothers, my sisters, life is nothing but a big test. Those who want Jannah in dunya are fooling themselves. The more you try to chase the Jannah of the dunya, the more you will be humiliated. The more you kick the Jannah of the dunya, which is worthless, and, you know, be patient and look forward to the Jannah of Akhirah, the more you will be happy, and the happier will be in the Akhirah. وَاتَّبِعْ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ. Follow what has been revealed to you. وَاصْبِرْ. Patience. And by the way, sabr is ibadah jaba'iyya. It's a congregational ibadah. Just like Salatul Jum'ah, we cannot do it by individually. It has to be done in a congregation. That's why it's important as a congregation to be connected with each other and to feel each other and to support each other. So we're able to make it safe, inshallah. حَتَّى يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْحَكِمِينَ. May Allah Azza make us from those who follow what has been revealed to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and what has been revealed to us. And may Allah Azza wa Jal make us from the sabirin and help us to stay connected with each other and unite us in Firdaus al-Anam and the community of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Wa jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.